Welcome back to Second Cup on WTXL.TV. I'm Cara Bailey, and the two lovely ladies that you see with us right now are Aurora Hansen and Angelina Way. They are joining us this morning to tell us about Experience Asia. Thank you so much for being here. Definitely appreciate your presence this morning. Now, you guys have a lot planned. It's going to be a full day event. I think it starts at like 10 a.m., goes all the way to 5. You got to pack tons and tons of activities in this, so you guys have plenty in store. Tell us, really, first let's get started about the background of the coalition that brought this all to being.
Okay, the coalition started in 2004 with a small group of people. It was actually started by the Big Bend Filipino American Association.
Okay.
And we were able to organize all the Asian groups in Tallahassee, and it has blossomed from a few members to a lot of members. And from the first event that we had, we thought we'd only get 200 people. 2,000 people came up.
Wow, for the very first event.
The very first event.
And
it's grown, and we're expecting 15 to 18,000.
That is a ton of people, and it's going to be amazing, as it is every year. Now, I want to back up just a bit. You said that you started with that one group, mm-hmm. and then found all of the other groups. It's amazing that you're able to unite everyone in that way. How many groups did you bring together?
Well, we had 10 countries that were represented in Tallahassee, and it was also due to John and Jane Marks. They were the ones that said, let's do it. He was the mayor at the time.
Right.
And we approached him. And Clydea from the Big Bend Filipino American Association was the one that really spearheaded the formation. And Lucy Ho. And so from there, it blossomed to all these things and involved the universities and the community, a lot of the organizations in town, service organizations, Leon County schools and stuff. So it's been very exciting. Very, very exciting.
And this is the 15th year that you guys are doing
this?
Congratulations on keeping it running for so long. You really have to have a strong following and lots of support in order to do that. Now, one thing that I do want to bring to the forefront right now is that we're going through a little bit of a transition. Aurora, you serve right now as the chair.
And my best friend, Angelina, she will be the next chairperson.
Well, congratulations to you. You're stepping into some big shoes. What are your thoughts going into the event this year?
I'm happy and I want to enjoy it. If we talk about, we have no time to enjoy it at all. We don't really sit down. We have never sit down and watch all the performances.
Oh, wow. Yeah, lots of performances are on deck. Now, this is something that I know because we partner, ABC 27 partners with this event every year. So we've been out there. I was out there last year. It is lots and lots of fun, and there are a lot of things to do. And just because I have this little bit of background, you have a kind of a performance history yourself, right?
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
I teach ballet in the city. And I also have a dance company at Tallahassee Community College, which is 18 years old.
Okay.
And so they, from that time on that we had the Asian Coalition, the dancers have been a very integral part of the festivities. So we perform all sorts of genres of dance.
And so, as you were saying, Angelina, you're going to be able to sit and watch that before you, like, really, really take the reins for everything that you guys are going to be doing next year, right?
Hopefully.
And so, it's not just performances. What else can people look forward to?
Food is a big thing. A lot of people love food. And this year, we have Korean food back again. We don't have it every year,
okay.
But hopefully from now on we have it every year.
Let's keep our fingers crossed.
Yes, maybe some people have heard about Korean barbecue, mm-hmm. bulgogi,
yes.
and sweet potato noodles, japchae, and besides, definitely a lot of people like kimchi.
Listen, I'm getting hungry just thinking about this. You just set out a whole platter for us. And that is definitely something that people look forward to. What about some of the events? I heard there was painting.
There's painting.
We have
a children's section so that we can steer them into, you know, with all the commotion, with all the events, we have an area for them where the parents can just sit down and say, okay, relax. And we also have demonstrations from different countries. So we have lantern making, we have how to put a sari on, how to the Japanese kimono. We have somebody that's doing the emperor's beard. It's candy, and they're going to toss it, and it's going to look like a beard. And we have the India mandala. They're going to be making it on the where they're at. And the Japanese community is very, very, very big. They occupy a quarter of the park. They have 10 booths. They have all these activities from painting to food to children's activities. So it's just a lot of stuff that we're going to be doing.
Awesome.
I don't ever get to see the stuff, you know, because I'm walking from park to park.
Yes. Yes.
So, but we are very, very, very happy that WTXL, actually ABC 27, yes, is back on board with us.
And let me tell you, Aurora, we are happy to join you. We are going to be down there. You guys, in addition to checking out everything that Asia Experience Asia has to offer, come by and see us. We like the opportunity to connect with you guys. We'd love to see you there. You can join us again this Saturday. It starts at 10 a.m. Lasts all day long, all the way to 5. We've got all of the details on your screen for you right now. You can also find them right here on WTXL.tv. Hey, stay with us. We'll be looking ahead to tell you what you can expect on midday right after this message.